Hello YouTubers, subscribers, followers, or people just happen to stumble across my little YouTube channel. Today is Saturday the 23rd of October, and that's the time. There. Today is another wedding, and it's actually not my booking. A friend, DJ friend of mine, called me I think 2 weeks ago and say, am I available today the 23rd? And I was. And obviously I got the booking that way. He got the booking from another DJ, so I don't know anything about that, but I do know the DJ that called me. In fact, he rang me today saying, am I available today? And I said, I'm already doing one. And he said, oh yes, apparently a DJ's got COVID. Now, I hope he's better, I hope he doesn't got it, long-term COVID and stuff like that. But yeah, so he said he's got COVID, so he's trying to find another DJ in his network to see if he can come for today. So yeah, today's a wedding, it's not my booking, so not too sure about any videoing. Didn't do a lot of videoing for last week because, to be honest with you, you know, you see people dancing, the dance floor, etc. It tends to be the same old, same old. So it was quite short. I'm going to a place called Bletchley, which is outside Milton Keynes. The nearest motorway will be M1 Junction 13, 14, but it's off there. It's off the A5, actually. It's a village hall community centre. It's got a big stage. It's a stage area. It's quite a big one, far as I can recall. I think I've been there many years ago. I know where it is because I used to sort of work in that area, so I know where it is. I have spoken to the groom, just to touch base with him, got the first song, just have a chat with him that he knows I'm coming and not the other guy who we booked. That's okay. He also told me that a road was closed, which is great because otherwise I may have not, but my sat nav would have given me a detour anyway. So yeah, so it's another wedding. This is the last wedding until December. I'm doing a Sunday December wedding. And obviously they're slowing down now for me. Fortunately it's not raining, which is fantastic. Winter's coming now, so it'll be interesting to see when I get home tonight how chilly the air is, because last Saturday I think it's quite mild, actually. It's quite warm, so weather's changed since then. So yeah, so I'm off and I'm going to leave around 4. It takes about 45 minutes. It starts at 7, but because of these roadworks, I just want to make sure that the detour isn't going to, you know, be a big detour. Sometimes it's just a couple of roads, and sometimes it's going to be quite a large detour out of your way. So yeah, so I start at 7. I told the guy I'd be there around 5-ish. Obviously, he said someone's there because obviously you've got to decorate the hall. They're not having a wedding breakfast. It's just purely the evening bit. They actually got married before. They went to Greece to get married. So this is like the party stroke reception. Okay, so I'll catch you when I'm actually at the venue, and we shall see what it is. I've changed my setup slightly different. I'll talk you through that. For my weddings, there was no weddings last year, was there? But the weddings I've done this year and 2019, wasn't it? 2019, yeah. I sort of have a set, moving heads, and recently the helix and my spherons. I'm not using the spherons, I'm not using the moving heads. I'm just going to use this helix and the American Stinger2. I've got two of them. I want to see what that actually looks like. So I'm having a bit of a change. I'm not doing the spherons. If it's high on the stage, because obviously it goes on my stand, the sort of the ballroom effect gets a bit lost. If you put it too low on the stage itself, it's too low. So I'm not going to do a sphere. I'm just going to have a look, see what they look like. Also, as a matter of interest, last Saturday's bride, Steph, left another 5-star review on Trustpilot for me, which is fantastic. Anyway, I'll see you on the other side. Right guys, this is as we walk in, champagne glasses. There's the office on the left. Come through now. The bar is through there, and this is the hall. Fully done, isn't it? Drapes, sashes, tablecloths and sashes, third party. All this is done by the venue themselves with extra. Twinkly little lights there. I thought it was Christmas tree when I first walked in. So that's the bar area over there. The kitchen's over there. I set up over here. I've got a TV monitor just there,
so the sticks are very close there. So obviously I've got the Chauvet Freedom sticks, I've got the Equinox foldable stand, I've got one, two, I've done the focus now, American DJ Stinger 2. This is a different setup for me, I've never done this way before, and the Helix, Equinox Helix there, XMG DJ 15 there. So I never had all these lights together at any one time, so I just want to see what it looks like. I did a test, it fills up the whole room. So I'm on the stage, is quite big. Obviously I've got the Virtus CS-1000s, see my mains cable, I didn't bring any Macs with me, no point, it's on the stage, and they got a little slide. They were married earlier on in Greece, that's a slideshow there, and that's taking up the space here, so I can't spread out the two sticks there. I was going to put one look further back, but so shall we have a look at what's around the back? I've been told I've got to cut the bass off because there is a limiter here, but they will tell me, they won't cut it off. So I've put the CS-1000s on vocals to cut the bass down as I can. Obviously I turn the bass down on a mixer, but I've been told. So obviously XMG DJ 15 with Virtual DJ Pro. I've got a Numark controller. Shure SM58 mic, which is corded. Switch box. The controller for the Equinox LX to take it off the Love Hearts. Cables. Just a box for weight. What else? Sony headphones. And the cables are best I can. I looked at the front, you can't really see it at the front, just the back it shows. So I've got all that going on. This is the first time I had the American DJ Stingers and the Equinox Helix out all at the same time. If I just show you what it looks like. And the lights, switch for the lights on the stage. That's what it looks like. Still seeing some stuff over there come right. In that corner, where's the camera corner? In that corner there, I can see some stuff, but that's, I can move that, that's mine. But the sticks do something, don't they? I think they do something, they add something. It's on Sound to Life right now. Further back. This is the view from where I am, looking out. That's where the horse goes. I've done a nice little job there, don't I? With the drapes, little twinkly lights, a Christmas tree thing. It's laid out like a proper breakfast meal, as opposed to a buffet. So this is my view. If I just stand up, I don't fall over anything. I've got the sticks on Sound to Light right now. They're doing their things. Something sticking out there, that's the screws from the stand. But I'm going back to the Virtus, going back to the Virtus CS-1000s. As soon as I walked in, the caretaker said to me that there's noise control. They do have a limiter, but I think it must be in their office, because she said if there's a problem, she'll come and tell me. But she said that when she's had people here before, if the bass is off, there's no problem. So with the Virtus CS-1000s, probably like a lot of bass bins, you have different settings. So I put it on vocal, which should cut down the bass. And obviously I can get less bass by on the mixer. Let's see how that goes, really. And obviously the other one, so I put them on what's called vocals, which I presume is now. It's a thin sound. It does sound a bit thin, to be honest with you. When I went out to listen to it, it's a bit thin. I have to see how much I can get away with, I don't know. But at least there's no limit to switch it off, so they'll come and talk to me and tell me to turn it down. They do have live bands here. I saw a poster outside for a ska band coming here, so obviously they must turn up the volume. But she said just turn down the bass and she'll be alright, so I did that, but it sounds a little bit thin, so. So people are coming in, it's 7 o'clock now, people are coming in. The bar is at that right hand side, they're getting their champers as they come in. The bar's there. Oh, so it's laid out like a breakfast, isn't it? A wedding breakfast. Not your normal buffet type of thing. There's wine on the table. Finish the music's got to finish at 11:45, I've been told. Obviously, the couple are slightly older, but the couple also are going to make sure assume that most of their friends are going to be that way. Just a stab in the dark, as I say. But yeah, today I brought out the Stinger 2 and the Helix. I've never done that before. I just wanted to see what it looks like. I normally bring the Helix out of my, what I call my wedding gear, with the sphere on normally and the moving heads. I thought I'd try something a bit different. And when the lights are off, I reckon they look all right, because the Stingers fill up everything. And that's without the laser. I haven't got a laser on the key. I haven't put a key in yet. Yeah, so that's that really. Nothing else really. Background music. Unobtrusive music. And you can see, so it's flashing at me. Play. I think that's a UH6, the American DJ thing. I've got lots of space. I mean, there's loads of space in the stage. This is a deep stage, so I've got loads of things. But I'm using the empty cartons there as a little table for my notes. Spare laptop. So I do carry a spare laptop, and I do carry a spare hard drive. It's a copy hard drive. And over there, no, sorry, it's in here. Sorry. And in that box is a just dropped the phone. In that box is a spare 4-channel mixer, just in case. The only thing I can't do is the speakers. If something happens to speakers, I don't know what to do. But what can you do, eh? There's something tells me otherwise. I've got no room in the car to carry anything else. So that's the view again, the view from behind. Yeah, the cable's all over the place there, right? But nobody can see that. I've done the best I can with the cables along there. I went to the front, you can't see it from the front. It's all at the back. Cable police. It's just another view, really, using a different camcorder. This time using my camcorder, not the phone. Keep finding out a battery of this thing, so I'm not too sure if it's this or the batteries are rubbish. But there we go, it's another view. People coming in. There's quite a few people. I'm not sure how many. I think there's about 10 on a table. It's about 100 people, I reckon. It's definitely like a wedding meal, you know, breakfast. Feels like a wedding breakfast, but it's about 10-ish, I think, on the table, and there's about 10 tables out, I guess, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, maybe 11, actually, so, but, you know, they cater for 180 turn-up, that would normally happen. So I've got the freedom sticks on sound to light, doing their thing. What else is going on? Normally this is the lull before the storm, or there may not be a storm, I don't know. I said this was not my booking, so I never spoke to the guy until I was handed over the booking. There wasn't much demand, really. He didn't demand anything apart from the first song, and there was another song going too sure, and I said maybe I'll leave that to the last song, so we'll work on that one.
Alex. years, the switch boxes, they're quite handy. They're really inexpensive as well. So that's all my rubbish. I have no idea how to control the lights. I'll have a look around in a minute. Anyway, so that's like a look around, quite a big look around really. It's supposed to start at 7, it's only 10 to 7. I started this background music at 6:30 while I was changing. There's probably controls here for the lights, but I can't. So anyway, I'm going to find them. All right, catch you when, oh, probably the first dance.
I've been out my Samsung Tab 10 tablet nowadays, using the AUX, just in case. I've got some songs on an SD card, but obviously I've got the phone as well, so hopefully I'll never have to use it that way. It's plugged into the SD AUX, which is here. And the level's really low. You see with the bass, it's like 10, 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock I reckon. I've got to say, there's quite a lot of people here this evening, and it's just after 7:30. So it's 8:15, I just announced the buffet's open, and they're all grabbed their food and obviously sit in their places. I'd say the stage area's a bit chilly. At least I've got a fleece I can put on if it gets too cold. Just announced the buffet. Right, they're going to do a few speeches now. They're opening up their champagne bubbles. Every table has at least two, I think, bubblers. I think at least two. You'll do a toast. Didn't want to use the mic, so they're going to shout. I found out that the dance floor actually is this area. They're not moving anything. And when the first dance is announced, they should turn down the lights. Like to find out. So that's what should happen. All the pops. So they would do the. I did offer them the mic, but they didn't want to do that. So. And what time is it? It's 10 to 9. Right, speeches are over. They've got to cut their cake in the corner.
Go.